Hello. So this video is a brief introduction into the Bitcoin blockchain simulator that I've been developing the last couple of weeks. And I just want to show you around a bit just so you can get an idea how this works. So when you first come to the page, you have two options basically. If you already know the basics of Bitcoin and blockchain, you can go to the straight to the simulator by creating a new wallet. But if you don't have the knowledge of Bitcoin, how blockchains work, I'd highly recommend you to start with the interactive tutorial. So you can go here and it brings you to a new page. And then you have several chapters that you can work through. To get a really profound understanding how Bitcoin works. And you will also have interactive elements where you can play it yourself, try it out. For example, the elliptic curve. You talk about digital signatures, about cryptographic hashes, and you can do it interactively. So once you've finished that, you've a good understanding of Bitcoin, you can go to the simulator and you can create a wallet. So, and you can also use it in German and English. You can switch the languages in the top right corner. So now let's stick with English. So now let's create a new wallet. So to create a key pair, a public and a private key, in this simulator, you can use a username that is linked to these keys. So you don't have to send your transactions to random numbers you can't remember. You can send it directly to a username. So let's create a user and let's call it tester. So let's generate a new wallet. And what you will see now is that you have now two keys, a public key and a private key. And you will see in the top left corner, you see the balance based on the currently longest chain that we're going to see in a second. And on the right, you have your keys again backed up. So, got it. And before we take a look into the blockchain, on the bottom, you can see all the wallets that are currently connected. So, we have three wallets currently connected to this blockchain. So, this is the current blockchain. It has 39 blocks. It starts all the way back at block zero. And you can see all the transactions that are in the block. Then the hash of the previous block, how they are linked, the nonce that was required to have a valid hash, and the hash is at the bottom. And you can see also the side chains that people tried to create, or what happens if you don't have valid blocks. Okay, so basically, this is the last valid block. And if we want to build our own block, because at the moment we don't have any balance on our Bitcoin wallet, so we need to either receive a transaction from another person or we need to mine a block to get the block reward. And that's what we try to do. So if we go to block mining here, so we can say, okay, we want to build block 40 that is built on Fire's block 39. And already includes our reward transaction of 12.5 Bitcoin, and we can add more transactions that have been broadcasted to us. So we can see it here. For example, here's a transaction that one where OnFire wants to send to voluntary to Bitcoin. We can verify the signature, we can add it to the block, and we can take the next, and we see that this particular transaction has an invalid signature. That means this is some kind of fake transaction. It was not really made from this wallet here. And we can also add simply all valid transactions. We see these three transactions are not valid. So now we have our valid transaction with two transactions in the block, and then we can start mining here by typing the numbers and by simply trying if we can find a hash that in this particular case starts with four zeros. This is the difficulty of the blockchain. And so we try that. And we also have an auto mine feature. We can activate it, and the computer, well, automatically searches for a nonce, a number here, so that the hash satisfies the four zero starting criteria. So, while doing that, we can take a look at new transaction. When we want to make a new transaction, we just go here, and then we can just enter the name we want to send something to, maybe on Fire. one Bitcoin, we sign our transaction with our private key, and then we can send the transaction. But at the moment, obviously, we don't have enough balance to send it. We can send it anyway. But, well, it doesn't make sense because nobody would possibly include it into a block. So then what else can you do? Now, this is all operating on the public blockchain. This is the blockchain you connected to the first time you enter the page. But you can also switch it and you can create your own blockchain or connect to another one that other people have created. So let's create a tester blockchain. And well, okay, it does not exist, so we can create it. And we can specify here the number of zeros that is required to find a block, and also the block reward that we're receiving, okay? So if we type in 2 zeros to make it easy, a block reward of 10, and okay. So then we connect to the other blockchain. We see, well, there is no blockchain yet because nothing has been mined yet. And then we can start to mine a block. And it shouldn't be too hard to find a block with 2 zeros. So let's try. So the speed here is a bit lower so that you don't find it immediately. So now we found a block that has 2 zeros. Accidentally, it actually has 3 here. And then we can add it to the blockchain. And now every computer that is at this moment, particular moment, connected to this tester blockchain will receive this pop-up and will receive this notification that a new block has been found. And then everyone can verify this block and add it to the blockchain. And so this will be the first block mined by tester. And now, hey, you can see we have 10 Bitcoin, a reward transaction. And then you can see the balance up here, and you can also see the number 211 brought it to us. Yeah, that's basically it. So if you want to know more how this works, if you have any feedback, so you can just, hey, see here, write an email or join the Discord chat. And so enjoy it, try it, and I'm open to any suggestions how to improve it or how to have a better documentation about how it works. So thank you and enjoy using it.